Welcome to First Steps with ASM, Model Desk Testing. Model Desk Testing allows you to specify and execute tests in Model Desk. Use Model Desk Testing to verify the simulation behavior or identify critical situations in a scenario. This video shows you how to create a Model Desk test, using the scenario pedestrians crossing as an example. The scenario pedestrians crossing contains two pedestrians that cross a straight long road. In the example in this video, we want to test for a possible collision between the ego vehicle and a pedestrian. First, let's create a new test. On the testing ribbon, click New. Save the new test. Then, click Activate. Model desk tests consist of logical test cases, concrete test cases, and validation functions. Logical test cases provide a rough test description. They specify the general environment of a test, such as its scenario, road, parameter set, and plotting configuration. Concrete test cases provide a more detailed test description than logical test cases. They are used to specify concrete values of the variables, so-called alias variables, that are modified during the tests. On the validation page, you can specify criteria to validate the test results and to provide further information in the test report. Let's look at the example used in this video. The ego vehicle drives on a long, straight road with two pedestrians crossing. In a model desk test, these general circumstances are described using a logical test case. In contrast, concrete test cases are used to vary the values of parameters for tests, for example, the ego vehicle's velocity. A validation function checks whether the parameter value of a concrete test case leads to an expected result, for example, a collision between the ego vehicle and a pedestrian. Now, let's specify the logical test case as follows. Scenarios, roads, and parameter sets are optional. However, plotting configurations are required. They specify the signals that are measured during the tests and that can be used to evaluate the test results. Next, let's look at the concrete test cases. In this example, we want to determine at what value the ego vehicle's velocity leads to a collision with a pedestrian. The ego vehicle's velocity is specified in the scenario. Select the ego vehicle's activity. In the Properties pane, go to Longitudinal Properties, Parameters, Final Velocity. This is the property needed for the concrete test cases. To modify the values of scenario or road properties in a model desk test, you must use alias variables that reference these properties. Right-click Final Velocity and select Add Alias. In Maneuver, find the new alias variable 1. Define a meaningful name for the alias variable 1. If you modify the values of alias variables, the values of their assigned property references are also modified. Save the Model Desk project and go to the test. Next, let's specify the concrete test cases. For scenario, click Plus. Then select the alias variable that references the eco vehicle's velocity. Right-click the new concrete test case and select Append to create additional concrete test cases with the same alias variable. Enter a different value for each concrete test case. Next, let's create a validation function to check if any of our concrete test cases result in a collision. Right-click the pane and select Insert. Model Desk provides some predefined functions to evaluate test results. However, you can also define custom functions using Python scripts. An example that you can use as template is installed with Model Desk. The linked plotting configuration, EuroNCAP, contains a sensor signal that reports if a collision occurred. If the signal value is zero, no collision has occurred, otherwise there was a collision. Therefore, define the validation function as follows. The test is passed if the value of the signal is zero, which means no collision occurred. All necessary settings for the Model Desk test have been configured so that it can be started. Right-click the logical test case and select Execute. Test execution might take a while. As a result, you get a verdict and report for the logical test case. In addition, you get a verdict, report, and a capture of the plotting signals for each concrete test case. In this example, a logical test case has failed because the third concrete test case results in a collision.
DSpace, your partner in simulation and validation.